C'est avec plaisir qu'on va discuter de l'une de mes séries préférées de l'année qui s'appelle Stateless. Et on a Cate Blanchett et Yvonne qui sont avec nous. Bonjour.
Bonjour, Louis.
Bonjour.
Yvonne, I'll start with you. We spoke a couple of weeks ago and you said that, you know, if you look exhausted, tired in some of the scenes in the miniseries, it's not just great acting. It's because you were breastfeeding your baby and you were not really sleeping at night. Is that true or partly true? Because I really love the way you work on that show.
Oh, look, I'd love to leave it all up to my acting that I look so tired. But no, it is true. I was definitely breastfeeding my child at night and he was still very much little. So it was a bit of a juggling act. The whole first year, really, of my son's life has been a little bit of a juggling act with working and being a new mum.
Every time I'm thinking about migrants, I'm watching news about that, I keep coming back to Stateless. It's something that I'm pretty sure is going to stay in my mind for a long time because it's so powerful. What about for you? Because you made it. So even if it's over a year ago since your RIPE production, is it the kind of project that you have a tough time to clear from your mind because it's so powerful?
Well, it took a long time to get up. It took a long time for Elise and Tony and I, who we developed the series with, to find partners who were brave enough to look beyond the politicized nature of the subject matter to the human drama. And also to understand that whilst it was set in the Australian desert as a prequel to our current woeful offshore processing of refugees and asylum seekers, when immigration detention was onshore, that it was a global issue and that was of global relevance. And so I've been very curious and heartwarmed by the international response that people have felt that it spoke to so many countries' experience and treatment of the world's most vulnerable people. You know, I mean, when you think about the overwhelming number of the displaced are children. You know, being as a parent, and I know you connected with that too, Yvonne, you know, you think, what if that was my child? You know, what if that was my sister, my brother, you know, and I think I'm really heartwarmed by the fact that people have connected with it outside Australia. And unfortunately, because it took so long to get the series up and running, we kept thinking, oh, well, this, it won't be relevant next year. Maybe we should do something else. But unfortunately, it's still of great importance, you know, that we look at the human face behind the statistics in the global displacement crisis.
They're going to kick me out, so I gotta go. Yvonne, Kate, thank you so much, and see you next time.
Thank you, Andrew. Thank you.